What up, what up, what up, fellow agents, Pure Prime here. Today I'm gonna show you my custom P416 build. And this is the damage with my Eagle Bearer. And look at my custom, guys. Booyah! Are you ready? Let's go! So, let's see, guys. My survivalist, or I'm rocking the survivalist, and yeah, mainly for this beautiful grenade, guys. A little bit for that 15% outgoing healing for my teammates, of course, and I'm loving this 15% protection from elites. And then yeah, in cover, gain 10% skill haste. It's pretty nice as well. And after that, I buffed up my submachine gun with 15%, my assault rifle, of course, with 15%, and I used 15% for my marksman rifle, because sometimes we want to switch up to the Nemesis when we are in the raid. But let's go to the build, guys. Just like you saw, I'm getting this nice custom P416. Almost up to the same level as the Eagle Bearer. So many people asked me to make a build with the custom, because the drop rate of the Eagle Bearer is, yeah, everybody knows, unbelievably low. I got lucky, of course, but yeah, there was a lot of hours in the raid. But yeah, I think I fixed it. I think I made a build that rocks the Eagle Bearer, or almost at the same level as the Eagle Bearer. So what did I do? I made a clutch critical hit build. So I went for a 9-3-5 build, and then of course with clutch. And what's clutch? Clutch is critical hits restore 20% health and repair 1% armor. Requires 4 or less blues. And of course an LMG, an SMG, or an assault rifle drone. So it's pretty hard to get only 4 blues and then the right amount of health. I'm only rocking 3 blues. So yeah, maybe if I found another piece I can use, or a better piece. But this is the build right now. I will definitely post it again when I have some upgrades for it. But yeah, you see I'm using this Elp Summit gloves with 22.8k armor on there, and I rolled that 12% assault rifle damage as an attribute. And I got a utility slot on there with 52 skill power, 337 chem launcher skill power, and 271 pulse skill power. And let's go to my vest. And I'm rocking this Venris group vest with 46.7k armor. And the attributes are 4.5% critical hit damage, 7% weapon damage, and I rolled a 40 or almost 41k health on there. That beautiful piece that you can buy this week in the clan vendor. And as a talent, I'm rocking Berserk, of course, and then Vital. And for the mods, I use an offensive mod, 1% weapon damage, 5% assault rifle damage, and 2% marksman rifle damage. And let's get over to the backpack. And the backpack is a 5.11, and I rolled their 14% critical hit chance on there. And that's why I'm using it, because I have another one, let's see, and that's this one. You see my health bumps up a lot, like 20k. I rolled that health on there as well, but it has health on kill and damage to elites. And I like to get vital on there and maybe damage to elites away, because yeah, I don't necessarily need it. But yeah, with this one, I'm losing 4% critical hit. So that's why I chose for this one, that 14% critical hit chance, 14k health, and 109 skill power, and then the talents, hard hitting and vital. And I put a offensive mod slot on there with 1% weapon damage and 5% assault rifle damage. And then I'm rocking for the other three pieces, I'm rocking the Wyvern gear. And why? Because the third brand set gives me 10% critical hit chance. And of course that first gives me 7% critical hit damage. So for my mask, I went for this Wyvernware with 23k armor. The attributes a yellow and a red, 140 skill power, and I rolled a 42% damage to elites on there. I got a higher piece from damage to elites, but it's on my other build, so I'm farming for a higher damage to elites because, yeah, I think I only need the damage to elites on my mask. So if I can find that 52 or that 55 that everybody is talking about, then I'm gonna roll that up. This, of course. But then we're going to my holster. And that's a Wyvernware as well. That 28.4k armor. I rolled a 16% critical hit chance on there. And I got a blue one with 21k health. And then I went for the utility slot with 79 skill power, 355 pulse skill power, and 187 chem launcher skill power. And then for my knee pads, I went for the Wyvernware, of course, with 29.1k armor. I rolled at 27% skill haste on there, and I got the talent cloaked. When your armor is depleted, nearby enemy skills are disrupted for 10 seconds. Can occur every 30 seconds. And that needs me to require 5 yellows. And I've got this offensive protocol on there with 1% weapon damage, 3.5% assault rifle critical hit damage, and 4% optimal range. And then, of course, I almost forgot to mention it, but I got Spotter on this mask. And why Spotter and why those 5 yellows? Because I'm loving Spotter, man. It gives you 20% weapon damage to pulsed enemies. It only require 5 yellows, so that's why I run a 9-3-5 build instead of maybe a higher red roll, so I got more base damage, but with that Spotter on there, I get a 20% extra weapon damage. So yeah, that's pretty nice, guys. That's OP in my opinion with this build. And then of course for the guns, I will show you the P416 as last, but I went for the tactical M1911 handgun. And yeah, mainly for that stop, drop and roll. While equipped, rolling removes burning, bleed and poison status. Can occur every 60 seconds. So yeah, that's why I rolled it on, yeah, and I got some mods on there. And yeah, it's not that useful because I don't use the handgun that much. And then for the second gun, I went for the Chatterbox, and mainly, of course, for his blabbermouth. While holstered, reloading your weapon within 5 seconds after a kill grants 20% rate of fire for 10 seconds. So guys, remember that. Remember that. If I kill somebody and I reload, I get blabbermouth, and for 10 seconds I get a rate of fire of 20%. And why do you need to remember that? Because look at my custom P416, guys. It's only at 19.2k damage, but that's because I rolled measured on there. The top half of the magazine has a 20% rate of fire and a 15% weapon damage nerf. And the bottom half of the magazine has a 20% rate of fire nerf, but has a 30% weapon damage buff. And then I got Allegro on there and protected reload. And look at that RPM, guys. 975. That's insane. But I said, remember that 20%. Because when I kill somebody, I get for 10 seconds 20% extra RPM. So that means 20% of, let's say, 1,000, because that calculation is a little bit easier. You get 20%, you get on 200 extra RPM. So you're coming on around 1200 RPM. So between 1150 and 1200 RPM on your military P416. And that is freaking insane, guys. That helped me a lot. I lost a lot of weapon damage, or a lot. I lost 15%, but I'm getting double the weapon damage when my magazine reaches the bottom half. And for the mods, I went for the highest critical hit chance I can get. So I put, like, let's see, 10% critical hit chance on there with the laser pointer and the reflex sight. Then, of course, the sturdy for those extra 20 rounds and that minus 10% reload speed. And then I went for stability because, yeah, I want to hit the head, of course. And that's giving you a lot of critical hit power. So, yeah, that's why I wanted that stability on there. I could go for 5% damage to elites or another 5% critical hit chance. But I chose for stability. And why did I explain spotter? And why I like it so much? Because with this build, and of course with the new update, because the new update buffed this build a lot, guys. Because I have 5 yellows on there, I got nice skill power. Or like on my knee pads, I got that 27 skill haste. So what did I do? I buffed my pulse, of course. And like you see, my cooldown is at 14.6 seconds. I got a mod on there for that battery that almost a K, and then at 127% skill haste. So that's why I'm buffing my pulse to that 14.6 seconds. And that's why I'm loving spotter, guys. But every 15 seconds, so to say, I get an extra 20% weapon damage. And I'm loving that, guys. And for the next one, I'm using the chem launcher. And yeah, this is pretty much a precaution because you want to play without your armor. When your armor is depleted, you get your 50% extra weapon damage from your berserk. And then if somebody hits you, you shoot back, you get a critical hit. And your health bumps up. So you just can stand 10 meters from a named enemy and you will always win. But I will show you that after this, because I got a lot of questions as well. Do the build video first and after that go for the gameplay. So of course I'm listening to all of you. I appreciate all the comments. I appreciate all the likes, of course. And keep them coming, guys, because you are my inspiration. And yeah, if you like to see a build, let me know. Just drop it in the comments and I will try and fix a nice build for you. But yeah, let's go back to this build. I went for that 58.5% heal because I have a little over 1,000 battery on there. And yeah, that gives me armor repair of 80k. So yeah, that's pretty nice if I'm way over my head and I just can pop it one time. It gives me 80k armor back. So back to business again. Yeah, and just like I showed you with the specialization, of course I'm rocking this incendiary grenade. I'm loving this grenade. It's pretty dope. But yeah, that's pretty much my build, guys. And this is the build I was working on for the last couple of weeks. The last two builds are pretty nice, but yeah, I understand when people ask me, please make a build for everybody and not only for the people that have a Eagle Bearer. But guys, in my opinion, I understand it, But in my opinion, it's a build. You know, if you switch your weapon, it's just the same build. So only the Eagle Bearer, of course, hits a little bit harder, but it's just the same build. I went for the custom P416 special build, but if I change it, if I go ahead and throw my Eagle Bearer and my Vector on there, I can still run this build. So with every gun, if it's, of course, a submachine gun or an assault rifle, then you can run this build. Because I buffed the assault rifle and I buffed the SMG. So you can choose, of course, but mainly I made this for you guys because you wanted a P416 build. So here it is, guys. And just like you saw in the intro, this build is almost hitting the same damage and the same DPS as the Eagle Bearer. And let's get over the stats. Gear talents, of course, we talked about it. And the weapon talents for the same. That blabbermouth, of course, that stop, drop, and roll. And there we are. The damage is 19,156 weapon damage. We got a critical hit chance of 50%. Critical hit damage of 40%. The headshot damage is 55. I got a range of 23 meters and a reload time of 2.5. The reload speed bonus is minus 10%, 0 accuracy and 20% stability. And then for the offense, we got 0% weapon handling, 10% all weapon damage bonus, 47% assault rifle bonus, and 15% SMG bonus, of course, and that little 17% maximum rifle bonus. Then we got 52 damage to elites and 29% health damage. And then if we're going over the defense, I've got a little over 190k armor. No armor on kill. I got an armor regeneration of a little below 10k. Max health of 144k. No health on kill and 72k health generation. I don't have any hazard protection and I'm working to that, but yeah, just first get that health up, of course. And I showed you the skills already and the Dark Zone perks. Yeah, that's where you are in the Dark Zone. So yeah, these are my stats from my gun and I will leave it up to the gameplay and I will show you a bit of the raid. Are you ready? Let's go.
I'm getting on plate. Yeah.
Down.
All right.
Get on plate in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. So my turret is still going, and I don't know what it did to
break it.
Drones.
Oh, okay, okay.
Aces.
Ninety percent.
I'm pulsing.
Very
nice. It did not proc. So, somebody else has to pulse.
Oh, shit.
Well, I'm healing in. Yeah, okay, I'm healing in. My healing hive will do work, so I'm you guys are gonna have to shoot these drones now.
No! Oh, it was close.
Someone watch my back, I'm gonna pick up Ryan. I don't have a revive kit.
Oh my goodness, my gun didn't reload. I'm down two.
Slim, can you
pick up Prime?
I'm gonna pick up Slim. Hold on. And Slim will pick up Prime.
Yeah, I'm just scamming.
Oh,
she
got
Prime.
Nice.
No, I pick up Prime.
Perfect,
nice.
Thank
Thanks.
You. We're gonna take a lap off, right?
What is shitting me? Where's it at?
We can go.
Prime, are you ready? You need a heal?
What's going on? Are we going or no?
No. No. So I don't know, but I think my turret is doing enough job, like, to help the drones.
It was. You stayed alive.
And it was for two rounds, I just burned it. Just
I
to
have
be...
the bullet.
Right, yeah. Right.
2 rounds.
I think I put mine around spot.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm totally down to wipe at the end and try to do it cleaner. For Prime's video.
Oh, it's all good. I'm practicing with this build. I need to.
Yeah.
We need to find the best way to play with it.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good
practice. I would highly recommend a Definitive Drone Prime. It saved my life many times.
Yeah, but. Yeah. Yeah, thanks. I'm gonna try it.
Reds are coming out. Reds are coming out. But definitely a good run still, though.
Because you'll see too, Prime, like if you look at, I know you're trying stuff, look at the other people who run the Reaper's Wyvern, they all run Definitive Drones.
Mm-hmm.
He's on two.
Alright, he's down. On plates in 3, 2, 1. On plates.
Yeah.
I got on a little late, but it's gonna still be good.
I can kill a yellow with half a mag. Awesome.
80%?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Whole thing. It didn't proc again.
Oh, left, right side? I'm sorry.
It's retarded. It didn't proc. But I'm gonna keep healing you guys, so don't trip. I got the drone. If you stay in the healing thing, you'll be good.
It's down. So remember two boomers.
Oh, I'm down.
I got you. Stay where you are.
God.
Stay where you are. Slim down.
I got shot in the back, running back. I'm sorry.
I don't know. My turret is. And it's easier for me to highlight the drones as well.
Like a snizzer.
Oh. Yep.
He's on.
One, three.
He's on one.
Okay.
He's down.
He's down. Oof, I have too many ads on me.
Yeah, we're shooting
them
from the back.
Let me take a left.
Okay.
Thank you.
I got that ad on right.
Thank you.
Nice, you got it. This.
God, my gun's not shooting. I hate
dog at two. Dog, you know?
Did you shoot me, Gold?
Yeah. Reflexes.
When there is ads, this bloodsucker is awesome. But when I shoot the razorback, it sucks.
Are you a bloodsucker? Oh.
Yeah.
I have to
draw.
He's
on four,
this.
Raw.
Yeah. And one.
Okay, four.
One and four is good.
Mm-hmm. Four is down.
Four is
one
down.
One is down.
Four is, one is down. My bad.
Oh, yeah. Get on plates in 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
Dog between.
Oh.
Watch out, Gold. There's a dog.
Sorry, 4, 3 again.
80, 90%. Oh, we're going to the back.
Four thing. get fucked. So I'll post again if I have to. Alright. Pulsing. Get procced, so if I have to, I'll pulse
damage.
Again. I'm pulsing.
I'm coming back.
It's really nothing for me to shoot.
No, I was running to the other side as well.
He's on one. Where is another one? He's on one. Okay.
He's down.
He's up.
Oh, I got a grenade on my ass. Yeah, one's down as well.
Down? Oh, we have too many ads up front. Let's go on plates in 3, 2. Are we gonna take a round?
Go. Oh, I was ready to get on. I'm on.
Okay.
I got
if we
on.
Finish it, we're good, but if not, we're screwed. We'll see. I got enough attacks.
Let's take down one wing then.
Well, I mean, the boomers don't come out, so we might as well just try to finish it.
90%.
Now, or?
Aces?
Let's see. Oh man, I got hit.
Dog at 4-3. Aces?
Nice.
Oh my god. With aces?
Yeah, we
damage.
Got it.
Go back.
Right. You want to be one of the computers?
Do we want to walk? Actually, no. So, Slim! Your build was perfect, bro. That was perfect.
Yeah. It only didn't work one time, one round.
Yeah. All the other rounds. So maybe we just need like a backup pulse, and then we're good.
Where is
maybe
he? We can... Right, or...
Want to wipe?
Oh, it's already gone.
Do we want to wipe and do it again? Like clean
you want to try to do a speed run? Now that we know your pulse works.
You want to try actual speed run? I'm down for that. Let's try a speed run.
Let's try
a speed run.
Oh, I'm not sure your pulse is down for...
Oh, you don't know how much time she has. Oh,
yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. No problem.
Fire blitz.
Are we wiping for this? No.
Wait, are we wiping or no?
No.
I think we're finishing it.
No.
I think Prime's gonna open the crate.
It's four.
Yeah.
Oh, Prime's gonna open the crate. You're right.
One is down.
I was shooting above you, Blitz. Don't trip. I was here.
That's true.
But yeah, that's it for today, guys. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, that notification bell. Pure Prime out.